Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo of PO Box Trainer. The Post Office Box Trainer is a basic combination of resistances which works on the Wheatstone Bridge. And the Wheatstone Bridge is the basic element by which we can or element or a circuit of resistances by which we can find out the unknown resistance. So by PO Box, we can find out the unknown resistance of this and also, we will find out the parallel and series resistances effect on the balancing of a Wheatstone bridge, and also we will find out the resistivity of any unknown material. So we will follow this all the experiment by description of the kit in further continuation with this video. So this is our trainer kit of Post Office Box Trainer. The order code for this trainer kit is 36339. You can use this order code to check the specification of various values and different experiments containing with this experiment box. So now we are going to describe all the elements. This is the schematic of Wheatstone bridge or the PO box with the 5 volt battery markable here, and this is the R1 or the R1 arm of this Wheatstone bridge, and this is the R2 arm of this Wheatstone bridge. So with this Wheatstone bridge, we can provide the supply on the B and D point with A and C point, and we will balance the both the arms by connecting a galvanometer between B and D points. So we connect a galvanometer, which is a digital galvanometer here, so in which we will find out the null value to balance the both the arms accordingly. So this is the R3 resistance. This will be connected with this different decade combinations. In this, we have provided 10 steps of 1000 ohm resistance, similarly 100 ohm resistance, 10 ohm resistance, 1 ohm resistance. This is the unknown resistance with the different values of potentiometers, in which we can provide any of the unknown value by move this potentiometer to any of the resistance value. So this will be the C and D point, which be connected with the R arm of this unknown resistance Wheatstone bridge. These are the on-off switch to on and off the galvanometer, and to provide the supply to A and C. Both the arms will be provided supplies, and this is the R1 and R2 decade or the dials by which we can select any of the value for the different arms. So this is the known value for balancing the arm or to provide the different values of R1 and R2 arms, which is the AB and BC arm. So by which we can vary the resistance of R3, so we will find out the unknown resistance accordingly, and we will follow different practicals. So in R1 and R2 we have 1 ohm, 10 ohm, 100 ohm and 1000 ohm, 4 different values for different ratios to provide it. So this is the user manual in which all the details about the Post Office Box Trainer is containing with the experiment on which we have going to perform in this video also. And these are the two wire samples by which we can find out the resistance and the specific resistance of the wires by using this Post Office Box Trainer. Some accessories for the patch cords to connect the all wire connections accordingly to the as per experiment. So we are going to perform the first experiment on this trainer board. So the first experiment is to determination of unknown resistance. So we will follow the procedure as described in the user manual. For this, we will connect the galvanometer E and F terminals to E and F terminals respectively to connect the galvanometer in line, and A and D terminals will be connected with the resistances A and D R3 terminal of the bridge, by which we can find provide the different values of resistance to nullify the value of galvanometer. And we will connect the C and D terminals to the unknown resistance, by which we can provide any of the unknown resistance using a potentiometer, and then we calculate and find out the unknown value of unknown resistance. So as per the manual procedure, we will connecting the galvanometer first. So we will connect E point to the E point of the galvanometer and F point to the F point of the galvanometer. Now we will connect the A and D point to provide the unknown decade resistances, the R3 decade resistances for the R3 arm. So A is connected to the A point and D is connected to B point. Now we will also provide the unknown resistance of the potentiometer Rx to the unknown resistance arm of this Wheatstone bridge. Now you will power on the trainer kit. First of all, make sure the both the switch of on and off the power supply is on the off position. All the decade should be at zero position. Now we will set the value at 1 ohm and 1 ohm for both the R1 and R2 resistances and turn on the trainer board. Now we will select any of the unknown value using this potentiometer. So value of the resistance is right now very unknown for all the instance. So we have to find out the value by using the Wheatstone bridge formula with this post office box trainer. Now you will on both the switches. Here the galvanometer is now overloaded because the resistance at the AD arm is zero. We will slightly start increasing the resistance. You can use the 1 ohm resistance so that you can going to the zero value approximately. You have to increase the resistance till you will find out the null value or the zero value in the galvanometer. Here we are now reaching about to the null value. And this is the null value right now in the galvanometer. So we have R1 is 1 ohm, R2 is 1 ohm, and R3 is of 1K plus 100 ohm plus 10 ohm. So we will calculate all the values accordingly, and this is the 3K. So this value is 3 plus 4K plus 100 and 400 and 10 ohm. Sorry, 400 and 4410 ohm. So this is our value. So we will put the value in the observation table. For the first value, we have set the value of R1 is equals to 1 ohm, R2 is equals to 1 ohm, and R3 is calculated by the decade box, which is the 4410 ohm. And this is the unknown value by which we have to put the all values in this formula, and we will find out the value of Rx with this trainer board. Now for another value, we have already set the resistance to another unknown value. Now 1 ohm are the R1 and R2. So the value that is selected to zero the galvanometer, we will find out, and then the value which is we will find out through the decade resistance boxes, it should be the equal value about the unknown resistance. For this instance, we have set the R1 to 1, R2 to 10 ohm, and we will on the both selector switches. Here the value is overloading right now, so we will start increasing the value. So this is the 1000 ohm here. Now we're increasing the value from 100 ohm instance. So our value is about 5560 ohm of the R3 arm. Now we will put these values in the formula given in the user manual. So accordingly, that we have found out the R3 is equals to 560 ohms, and R1 is selected 1 ohm, and R2 is selected 10 ohm. So for unknown resistance, we will put the value in the formula given in the user manual. So R3 into R2 upon R1 is our the output. So we'll put 560 into 10 upon 1. So our unknown resistance is 5600 ohm is our unknown resistance. Now we will do not change the unknown resistance for this instance, and we will verify the value with some another properties. So we will increase the R2 to 100, and here the galvanometer is showing some reading, so we will try to nullify the value. Here value is increasing, so we will decrease value, and 5 here, so this is 57 value from the decade. Now similarly the R3 for this practical, we have find out the R3 is 57 ohm, R1 is 1 ohm already, and R2 is 100 ohm. So we will put these values in the formula. For S is equals to 57 into 100 and 1. So our S is 5700 ohms. This is approximately 7, completely the same resistance that we have find out in the last practical. The percentage error can also be determined with all the different values we have providing in the user manual and to perform the experiment. So our next experiment is to verify the law of resistance in series and parallel. For this we will follow the procedure. For this we will connect the galvanometer E and F terminal to E and F terminal respectively. Then we connect A and D terminal to the R3 terminals of the bridge, and then we take two resistance of 820 ohm as R1 and R2 and check them with the multimeter, and then we connect it to series in parallel to different combination on the C and D blocks. Now R820 is the reference value for the resistance. We can connect any of the resistance value in series and parallels or the different values. So for this instance I have two resistance of 1k. The value of the resistances can be determined by the bands on the resistance, and these are the two resistance of 1 kilo ohms. Then we connect these resistance in parallel and series in both the experiments, and then we find out the series and parallel effect of, and then resistance law of series and parallel in the experiment. So we'll start doing the connections as per the user manual. Now we will follow the procedure. For this we will connect galvanometer. First E will connected with the E point, F connected with the F point, and A will be connected with A, and D will be connected with D. Now to provide the resistance in series and parallel, we will use this crocodile type patch ports which is also provided with the accessories. So we will connect C and D point to the crocodile patch cords. So first we will doing the parallel connections of these resistances. So we will connect resistance in parallel. So connect both the points through this alligator skip and put this here. Now we will turn on the trainer board, make sure all the points should be at 0 first. Now R1 is selected 1, so we will also select the R2 is 1 and increase the R3 resistance in steps so that we will reach up to 0 value. Here the value is 500. So the 500 is our value of unknown resistance. So as we put the value 500 in the unknown resistance value, because R1 and R2 are 1 ohm, so the value of R3 and unknown resistance should be equal. So R3 value is right now we are getting 500 ohms. So our unknown resistance value is also 500 ohms. Now 500 ohms is due to that we have connected the resistance in parallel. So for parallel resistance, the Rx will be 500 equals to R1 into R2, which is 1 ohm into 1 ohm, and divided by R1 plus R2. So this is 2 kilo ohms. So in the, this is in the kilo ohms value, and as I put this 2 into 500, so our value is satisfied that 1K is our resistance that is connected in the parallel. So this is our value and the verification of parallel combination of the resistance. Now we will do this experiment in the series combination also. Now for series combination, we just need to connect the resistances in the series combination. So we will pull out the both alligator's clip and then connect the resistances in the series. Here 1K and 1K is connected in the series. Now we will again do the same experiment on the trainer board. Here we will again try to zero the value. For this we will increase 1 and 2. So this is approximately 0 in the galvanometer, and the value from the R3 is 2000 ohms. So we have connected two resistances in the series. So similarly, the value of unknown resistance, because the resistance 1 and R2 is the same as the last experiment, which is 1 and 1, and the R3 is we are getting what is 2000 ohms. And when we connect two resistances in series, the output should be the combination of the both resistances, is the addition of both the resistances. So we have connected 1K and 1K resistance in series, so 2000 ohms are the series resistances connections. So this is how we verify the series connections of the combination of the resistance also, by using this PO box trainer kit. Now for the third experiment, we will determination of resistivity of a material of a wire. So for this experiment, we will use a specific type of materials like magnin, nichrome and constantan. For this, different types of material are used to provide the different specific the resistance, and then we will follow the procedure and then calculate the output for the specific value of the resistance. Now we will follow the procedure accordingly. We are also providing two different types of resistances so that we can find out the resistivity of both the materials. So we will follow the procedure to calculate the specific resistance of an unknown material. For this, we will start connecting the galvanometer first in the bridge arm. So we'll connecting E with E, F with F. Also connecting R3, the variable resistance, to AD arm, and to connect the unknown resistance wire, we will using the alligator clip on the CND arms. So we are using an unknown resistance wire of 1 meter in the length, so this is our wire of 1 meter in length. So we have to measure the resistivity of this material. For this, we have to find out the specific resistance of this material, and the length is given is 1 meter. We will find out the gauge or the cross-sectional area for finding out the radius using the screw gauge. Properly connect or place the wire inside the screw gauge. So we are getting the diameter of this wire or this by the screw gauge is 35 or 38.38 mm. Here 0.38 mm is the output. So we will use this in the calculations. Now we will connect this wire using alligator's clip. Try to make most of the end connections so that we will get the accurate values. Here both the ends has been connected now in the unknown resistance arm. So we will also find out the unknown resistance of this wire, and then we will find out the resistivity of this material. Turn on both the toggle switches to connect the galvanometer. Now we will increase the resistance so that value of the resistance unknown resistance should be going to zero. If the value is not going zero on increasing all the resistances, then we have to change the ratio arms resistance. For this I am just increasing the R1 value so that the division by 10 is increased, and now we will increase the value to 100. Here the value is still not getting, so we will now increase the value to thousands. Here value is now zero. Just make sure that at which instance the value is not zero. So this is 10k. So the resistance, the R3 value is 10k and R1 value is 1000 for this, and R2 is 1. Now we will put this all values in the formula given in the user manual. So we have calculated R1 is 1000, so R3 that we have got is 10,000 10k, R2 is 1 ohm, and R1 we have selected to 1000 ohm. So when we calculate this, we are getting the unknown resistance of this wire is 10 ohms. So this is the unknown resistance of this wire is 10 ohm. We have measured the cross sectional area, which is, or diameter, which is 0.38 mm for this. So the radius should be the half of this 0.38 mm, which is equals to 0.19 mm. Now we'll put these values in this formula, and then we will get the specific resistance of this wire. So this is how we find out the unknown resistance using this PO box, and we also find out the and verify the law of parallel and series combination of resistances, and we at the end we have also find out the resistivity or the specific resistance of an unknown material. So you can do all the experiments as I described in this video with this trainer board, and while doing this trainer board experiment you can follow the details in the user manual for proper setup and the proper study of this trainer board. And then if you find more difficulties while working with this kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. Thank you.